English class. Today's our topic is nouns, gender. So our last class we discussed already about the nouns and the types of nouns, right? So the naming words, as you know already, right? The naming words we can call as nouns, and the types of nouns, the five types of nouns also we discussed already. So today we are going to discuss nouns, gender. So what is called gender? Gender is a category of noun. So in nouns, gender is a category of noun. So four genders are there in English grammar. Four genders are in English grammar, which are they? The first one is masculine gender, second one is feminine gender, and the third is common gender, and the last fourth one is neutral gender. So four genders are in English grammar. The first one masculine gender, second one feminine gender, and third common gender, and the fourth neutral gender. So we are going to discuss the first one, masculine. So masculine gender is the first category of gender. So nouns, we can the gender in nouns, the gender four types are there: masculine, feminine, common, and neutral. The first one masculine gender. What is called a masculine gender? So the names of all male, so male and female, the gender, if you sometimes we can see for the applications, there you can see this word there, right? Gender. So in that part we need to fill up male or female there, right? So here the masculine gender denotes all the male names. All the male names denotes in masculine gender. So names of all male persons or animals. Names of all male persons or animals we can call that in masculine gender. So in masculine gender denotes all the names of male persons or animals. For example, the boy, father, king, these all are male characteristics, right? That means boy always denotes a male person, right? And the father is also always denotes a male person, right? And the king is also denotes always a male person only, right? And the last one, lion. Lion is an animal, right? And this lion is also a female. That animal only we can call as lion. So another word is there for this female lion. For female lion, another name is there. So for male lion, only we can call as lion. Is it clear? So these are some examples for masculine gender: boy, father, king, lion, and cock, brother. So these all are some examples for masculine gender. So second one is feminine gender. So second one is the feminine gender. Feminine gender, names of all female characteristics. That means it will always denote the names of female characters only, right? That means, for example, you can say girl, mother, cute, and diner. These are the examples I have written over here. So the girl always will denote a female person only, right? A male person, a male student, we cannot call as a girl there, right? So this word girl always, this noun always will denote a female name only, right? So the names of all female we can call as feminine gender. For example, girl, mother. Mother is also always denotes a female person, right? That's why the person, names of a person, female persons, we can call as in feminine gender category. Okay. So I told you already, a female lion we can call as lioness. So names of any female persons or animals will come in this category. Which category? Feminine gender. So the first one, masculine gender, names of all male persons or animals. The second one, feminine gender, the names of female persons or animals. Is it clear? So the third one is common gender. What is called a common gender? What will come inside this category? So like these examples, doctor, friend, student, these are some examples for common gender. That means if the word, if you see the word doctor, a male person also can be a doctor and a female person also can be a doctor, right? So these type of nouns, a friend also, a boy also can be a friend and a girl also can be a friend, right? And student also, girl students also is there, and boy students also are there, right? So these type of nouns, either male or female, that type of nouns we can will come inside this category, common gender. So these type of gender nouns we can call as common genders. Is it clear? So the last one, is neuter gender. So the word neuter, N-E-U-T-E-R is the spelling of this word. So the neuter gender, which nouns will come there? All the non-living nouns, non-living things, that means the things don't have the life, we can call as the non-living things, right? So like that, pen, desk, book, table, you can see these all are non-living things, right? So these non-living things, names like pen, desk, book, table, car, building, these all are non-living things, right? So these all nouns will come in this category. Which category? Neuter gender. Is it clear? So the nouns, gender, four types of genders are there. First one is masculine gender, second one feminine gender, third one woman gender, and fourth is neuter gender. I know you know already, right? The difference between these four, right? So male, masculine, female names, feminine, and either male or female, we can will come inside common, and neither male nor female will come in this neuter gender. Why neither male nor female? That means pen, desk, book, this type of things, non-living things, we cannot tell it as male or female, right? So neither male nor female in which category? Neuter gender. Is it clear? So let's see this example, this sentence. My brother Arun and Mr. Prakash, daughter Kavya are friends. They went to same school. So let's see this sentence as an example. So here we can see a lot of nouns are there, right? So the naming words all we can call as nouns. So in this sentence, brother is a noun and Arun is also a noun and Mr. Prakash is also a noun and daughter, Kavya, friends and school also. So a lot of nouns we can see in this sentence, right? But here, this word brother, it will come in, it will denotes a male person, right? So this is a masculine gender. So in this sentence, brother is an example for masculine gender. And next here, daughter. Daughter always will denote a female person, right? So this word we can tell us in feminine gender, right? So this daughter will come in this feminine gender category, and brother will come in masculine gender category. And the next one you can see, the friends. So friends will come in which category? So friends, either male or female, right? So friend can be either male or female. So we can call it as in common gender category, right? And the next one is there, and the last, school. So school is a non-living noun, right? So this non-living noun always will come in which category? Neuter gender category. So here in this sentence, brother is in masculine gender category and daughter is in feminine gender category, and friends will come in common gender category, and the school, the non-living noun school, will come in neuter gender category. Is it clear? So let's see the formation of feminine noun. So the formation of feminine noun, how we can form a feminine noun. So there is no fixed rule for that. For some nouns, by adding the letters E-S-S, E-double-S, by adding E-double-S into the masculine form, we can form this feminine gender of that masculine form. So let's see that lion. Lion is an example for masculine gender, right? So lion plus this letters E-S-S will come lioness, right? So lioness is the feminine form of this masculine gender lion. So how we form this lion plus ESS? We add ESS with the masculine form of lion. We return here it as lioness. So that is the feminine form of this lion. So like that we can make some nouns, we can make this feminine masculine to feminine, add ess with the masculine form. For another example, host. Host with the ess we can make it as hostess. So hostess is a masculine feminine form of this host. Is it clear or not? But we cannot use these rules for all the formation of feminine genders. So this one is just an example for ess adding, and then we'll get the feminine form, some nouns only here, right? So the next way, side changes we need to make before ess. So here we just directly add ess with the masculine form, we got this feminine form, right? But in some cases we need to make some side changes with this masculine form before adding ess. So then only we will get the correct form of feminine gender. Let's see some example for that. Actor. So what is spelling of actor? How we can spell actor? A-C-T-O-R. So the actor is a masculine gender, but the feminine form of this actor is actress. How we made this? We cannot make, if we are making, if we add ess directly here, it will not be right. That means actor, we made some slight changes here. Actress. Actress is the right form of this feminine form for actor. So we made little changes over here, right? The spelling. A-C-T-R-E-S-S. So all nouns we cannot change like this, adding ess, okay? So making the feminine. So here actor we made a slight changes here, and add ess, we got actress as the feminine gender. And in this case, tiger. Tigress. Tigress is the right spelling. Okay, T-I-G-R-E-S-S is the right spelling for tigress. So that way you will get the feminine form of tiger as tigress. So if you are adding ess with this tiger, it will be wrong. So what we need to do? We need to make some small changes here in spelling, then only we will get it. So these are some formation cases. And another case, by using completely different word. So here we made add ess only with the masculine name, and here we just make a little change over here and add ess, and in some cases we will get the completely different word. Here for an example, father is a masculine gender, and feminine gender for father is mother. That is a completely different word. And king is a masculine gender, and feminine gender for this king is queen. Here we, in both cases we use the totally completely change different sentences, right? So different words. So this type also will come. And at last, sometimes we can see by adding another word, which that means in the case of compound words, that means more than one word will come in a sentence, like a gender in the case of grandfather. For an example, grandfather, we can see a compound words here, right? Grand and father will get the, together will get grandfather. So grandfather is a masculine gender, right? So what is the feminine gender for grandfather? Feminine gender for grandfather is grandmother. So this compound words case, one, the main noun we will change to a feminine case. So then only we will get the grand will same both cases, and the gender form of father only we change as mother. So in this case we adding another word, right? So for getting the feminine gender, so grandfather, feminine gender is grandmother. Like peacock. Peacock is the masculine gender form, and the feminine gender form for peacock is peahen. P-E-A-H-E-N. Because cock is a masculine gender and hen is a feminine gender for that. So peacock will become peahen as in feminine gender. So these are the formation of masculine to feminine genders. So nouns gender, four types are there: masculine gender, feminine gender, common gender, and neutral gender. And how we can identify it, that also we discussed already, right? And the examples are very simple only, that also you learned already, right? And after that, the formations also we discussed now already, right? So So this is not that much difficult. It's a very simple thing only. So nouns, in the case of nouns, we already learned about what is called a noun and which are the types of nouns. The five types of nouns we already discussed. Common, proper, and abstract and collective. These all we already material noun also we already discussed. And today we discussed already the nouns genders. So genders are the category of nouns. Four categories and examples and the formation also we discussed already. Is it clear? So I hope you all clear about these nouns and the types of nouns and the category and genders also.